But all right, boys, we are going first in this game, playing the best deck in format right now. It is Pika Rom. According to Limitless Qualifier, day two was chock full of these things, so I'm giving the deck a go for myself. Let's see how good it really is. And so far, it's pretty good. So we're coming up against a Mew Box deck that is also playing Malamar. A very interesting hand where we have a quick ball, and so obviously that's going to be for Dedenne, but I just want to use this card to draw two cards. Obviously, I draw Professor Researches because why wouldn't I? Then we're going to go for Dedenne and just get rid of all my Professor Researches because, you know, this game loves me. That's all right. At least we got this quick ball for next turn. It's not terrible. Turn one, going first, definitely could have been better, but is what it is. Opponent does get the Mew down on the field, and then he's gonna play energy on to his Gengar Mimikyu. Whorehouse GX is gonna happen, so now I can't play cards from my hand, which is wonderful because I just drew Professor's Research. But that's okay. I'm going to electrify. Still get to do things, which is nice. And then it's going to go back to our opponent here. And he's probably going to just go for another energy and just unga bunga me with the Poltergeist. Yeah. 250. Feels good, man. All right, so now we're gonna do that. Draw for turn. Oh, we draw another Professor's Research. Like, why? Come on, game. Ah, big dumb. This game is actually the big dumb. Alright, go for that. Draw some cards. Oh, of course we draw speed energy now. Alright, cool, cool, cool. Gonna do that. Dance of the Ancients. Very nice. Then, oh, I'm gonna have to... Yeah. I'm gonna have to retreat with Zorora, just so I get that free boy retreat. And then I'm gonna go for the full blitz. Get my four energy left in deck. Put three on there. And it doesn't really matter what he does. I'm going to be able to tag bolt, which is cool. Well, the tag bolt may have been kind of a big dumb, because, well, at least setting up tag bolt, because he's got the Mew, the little bench barrier Mew, but that's okay. Just draw into boss's orders, it'll be fine. So now he's going to switch into the Esper here. And that's going to be an empty hand supporter. Yep. As always. You know, our opponent can't just brick. You know, it's always going to make it hard on us. That's okay. All right. So Latias will eventually come down from our opponent here. Going to be it. All right. Let's make it happen. So now we're going to do here. Is it any lightning? Five basics. So it's any five basic. So let's go speed energy, draw some cards, feels of a good man, because we did draw into the boss's orders. So now I'm going to boss's orders, get rid of the Mew. Don't want to leave him hung out to dry, so I'm going to leave through that. We went to Bolt Storm for big damage, 280, take the knockout. If it was that much, I should have just targeted the Mew Mew, but whatever. Yeah, I probably should have targeted the Mew Mew with that. It's whatever. Psychic Recharge coming in for our opponent here. He's going to put it onto the Mew. Press his research again. And our opponents are never really ever starved for supporters. So, feels good, man. Feels good, man. All right. So, Cherish Ball comes down. He's going to search for Solgaleo Lunala. No GX attack, which is good. So then there's no Light of the Protector BS going on. I don't think this deck would ever play Lilies for that anyway, so it is what it is. Alright, so it plays the Absol, which doesn't do anything, because free retreat. Alright, let's see here. Let's go. The thing is, I could play Jirachi and try to go for another boss's orders, or I could just Volkner, which I think I'm going to Volkner. Alright, so I do have Eldegoss, I have boss's orders still in deck, so I can go for my energy, and I can go for Quick Ball. Alright, so we're going to go play the energy down on here. Play energy switch. Switch energy off of there. Put it there. Actually, I could go for Dedenne and I potentially try and go for game. I think I'm going to need three Electro Powers, though. So I'm going to have to check to see if I even have access to it before I do that. Three Electro Powers? Oh, I have zero. All right, never mind. Gonna play the Eldegoss, grab the boss's orders for next turn. Play that, 310 damage. Go one, prize. And we're pretty much set up no matter what. Unless our opponent has a reset stamp, it should be a GG. Even if he knocks me out with Poltergeist, it's fine. Retreat into the Malamar, which for some reason he thinks that's a good play. Oh, he's going for more energy. Okay. So it's 4 energy on here. Okay. Reset stamp. Does come down from our opponent, unfortunately. But we do draw into Dedenne, which is nice. Professor's research as well. It's all right. We got plenty of ways to draw cards. We should be able to find a boss's orders in here somewhere. As long as we find a boss's orders to pick off this, then we're good. It's a very impressive showing from our opponent here, but this should be a wrapped up game. I just don't see what he has that. I don't really see it. So he could attack with this. He can't GGN, so he's got Calamitous Slash. I just don't see it. Balloon's gonna come down for my opponent here. All right. Even more plays. Oh, he's taking a really long turn, not gonna lie, considering my turn's gonna be relatively simple. Cosmic Burn. So he's going to do the guaranteed 230, which is smart. We're going to go promote this. So we can go into this just in case we don't get it. But if we do, which we should be able to. And play that. Grab the Pikarom out of the deck just so it gets out of the deck. We got 2 bosses' orders. Hopefully we can get there. Plus a speed energy, there's our 6 energy. There's the boss's orders, boys. And unfortunately for my opponent, that is gonna be a GG. I'm gonna retreat into the Pikarom. I got scared for a sec. I thought this was only 2 energies. And we're gonna go Tag Bolt. And then I'm gonna do that. 200, 170, take 4 prizes in the same turn. And that was easy. I just shouldn't hit that button. It wasn't that easy. Alright, boys, got deck list here for you. It is the Pikarom list. And we're gonna get right into it here. We got ourselves the 2 Bolton Vs, help us out with the energy acceleration, of course, with the Electrified. It does a ton of damage. 30 more for each lightning energy attached to all your Pokemon. That, of course, includes Boltund. So with the 16 energy in this deck, that's a lot of potential damage. It's a lot, be a little bit too much of a big brain math for me, but I'll throw it up on the screen there somewhere. And then, of course, got the 3 Dedennes for that hard draw power. You got 2 Pikachu Zekroms. Is a good attacker, of course. Full Blitz, being able to pull the energy out of the deck. Tag Bolt, taking the 4 prizes like we did in the showcase game. But of course, Tag Bolt, a very dangerous, probably one of the best GX attacks in the entire game, being able to snipe the bench and do a ton of damage to the active as well. Then we got the 1 Alolan Raichu tag team. They didn't see too much. They didn't see any play in this showcase, but it certainly helps out if you can't hit the one shot. Being able to paralyze things is very good. Then you got Coco, helps with energy acceleration, and then you got the Zoroark to give yourself free retreat, playing 1 of each of these 3. We are also playing 2 Jirachi with the Stellar Wish, you know, good setup card. And then to round out the Pokemon list, we are trying out the Eldegoss V. I'm not 100% sold on it yet, but in some of my matches it worked, some of it didn't. So far I am going to recommend it for this particular list. Anyway, we're going to move on here to our trainers. We got our four Electromagnetic Radar, a good search card. We got our four Electropowers, helps us boost damage. Gives us the two energy switch to switch the energies around as well as quartz with the tag switch. It gives us a lot of flexibility in how we can approach each engagement with our opponent, which is really nice. Got those singular great catcher just to pick off the Dedenne's, which a lot of people are playing. So just having that one of great catcher to as an item that you're also able to use, let's say with Volkner, is a very good strategy indeed. It's also another discard outlet for Tapu Koko. So just the one great catcher is good enough. Then of course, got the four quick balls. It's a standard staple at this point. Got the four switches to go along with our Zorora, just so we can get Jirachi out of the active spot if he's stuck there and he's asleep. And then of course, got the one Thunder Mountain. So you're not gonna be winning any stadium battles in this deck, but you're not really expected to in Pikarom. As we go over to the supporters here, we're playing our two bosses orders. It's Lysander, it's too good. We got the one Malolana because a lot of our boys are thick, and it's another retreating option, and of course being able to heal is pretty good. Maxing out on the Professor's Research, and we've got two Volkners. And as mentioned earlier, we are playing 16 total energy. We got the four speed lightning energy, which of course lets us draw cards if we play it onto a lightning Pokemon, which is basically the entire deck. And of course we got the 12 basic energy. But let me know, guys, what you think of the deck list down in the comment section down below. And if you're new around here and you want to see me play games live, why not check me out on Twitch. A link to that is in the description below, as well of course the deck list in PTCGO format, so you can try this thing out for yourself. And if you really like my content, why not consider giving me the subscribe over here on YouTube. It's the red box. Hit the bell so you do not miss another upload. So until next time, boys, this has been Derek for Table 500, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.